Raider Nation, what's going on? You are watching our post-game reaction show after the Raiders' 17-13 win over the Denver Broncos. I'm going to keep wearing this jersey. The last three times I've worn this, the Raiders have won. Spam down in those comments, just won, baby. It was not pretty. Derek Carr did not play well. Let's face it. Derek was not the reason the Raiders won this game. The MVP of this game was defense, and I want every single person that comes across today's show to spam in the comments defense, because this question, who was the Raiders week 16 MVP? The answer was defense. A Derek Carr interception led to a Broncos touchdown. A Josh Jacobs fumble led to another Broncos touchdown. 10 points off turnovers. If it wasn't for those turnovers, the Raiders, this game would have been an absolute blowout. So we're going to answer questions, Jack, before we go to that. So I want you guys to use hashtag Raiders or Super Chat to get your questions, your comments on today's post-game reaction show. Raiders are 8-7, baby. 8-7. Still got a chance. Let's go to Juicehead89. What up, Mitch? Extend Crosby and Jacobs. I'm not extending Jacobs. Sorry, I know he had 100 and whatever amount of yards today. He had a bad fumble. I'm not paying Jacobs $7, $8, $9 million a year. If he wants to play on a cheaper contract, sure, maybe. But I'm team draft or running back. Crosby, though, yes, in a heartbeat. Let's go to WMitch6. Can we get in? That's what she said. Is it? Actually, I don't know if that makes sense. Yes, the Raiders are 8-7 right now. The Ravens are 8-7. The Chargers are 8-7. They absolutely can get in. You still have control your own destiny. You have a tough game against the Colts. You have a tough game against the Chargers. But the Chargers lost to the Texans. If you can beat the Colts, hey, man, you just never know what can happen. Now, again, guys, use hashtag Raiders or Super Chat to get into our post-game reaction show. I know we got some Super Chats we can get to as well. Now, if you want an awesome deal, because maybe Santa didn't bring you anything for the holidays, that's a you problem. Maybe you got coal. But we do have an awesome deal going on. Go to chatsports.com/Raiders sale. Whether you need a T-shirt, whether you need a polo shirt, a sweatshirt, shorts, pajamas, pants, shoes, if you go to chatsports.com/Raiders sale, that link below, it's in the comments and in the description. We're going to hook you guys up with some awesome Raiders gear. So please, if Santa didn't bring you anything, don't worry. We got you covered. Well, let's go to Wild on 14. I guess if it's Carr's fault when the team loses, makes it when some credit when they, regardless of how bad they played, your thoughts. I'm not always saying it's Carr's thought. Like, I don't think the way Raider Nation Twitter, Raider Nation Instagram does. I think the way I think. Carr deserves blame sometimes, yes. In today's game, Carr was one of the biggest reasons why the Raiders struggled. Carr, in fact, I think out of everyone who played on offense, was one of the worst players today on the offensive side of the football. Offensive line played good. Jacobs, after his fumble, played really good. I like the adjustments the Raiders made. But why am I going to give a lot of credit to Derek Carr when the Raiders' defense realistically held the Broncos to 3 points? I'm not going to give credit to Derek Carr. He did not play well today, no doubt about it. So what's your one-word reaction to Carr's performance up against the Denver Broncos today? I'm going to say bailed out or saved, because the fact that DC had a costly fumble, the fact that DC had an interception, I mean, if the Broncos make that field goal because of the Carr fumble, it's a totally different game. Carr's interception led to basically the only real touchdown I'll say that Denver had. Sure, they had a touchdown also in this game, but like, my one-word reaction is saved. My one reaction is bailed out, because their Carr was bailed out because of the Raiders' defense. Let's go to Josh Child, Super Chat time. I love how the D did not give the big runs plays and held Denver on a low rushing yards. I mean, my key to victory here for the Raiders coming into this game was how can the defense slow up the Broncos' offense? And I get it. It was Drew Lock. But Denver had only 8 first downs, had only 40 total plays, 140 yards on the ground, 18. Every single person watch right now, type that in the comments, 18 rushing yards. You held the Denver Broncos. Like, people do not realize how much of a dominant performance this game was. The Broncos offense had 158 total yards of offense. In fact, I'm going to go on Twitter right now and tweet that out. Broncos had 158 total yards of offense. Like, that's how amazing the Raiders' defense played today. And I don't want people to, like, not discredit how amazing the Raiders defense played. So, Josh, I appreciate your super. Well, let's go to Daryl. I love Carr, but he got to go. I like Carr, too. He's probably the best Raiders quarterback I've ever seen. He is the best Raiders quarterback that I personally have ever seen rooting for this team. But he is not the answer. If the Raiders had a quarterback with this defense, guys, this game's not even close. The Raiders have scored over 17 points one time since Week 9. Since Week 9, the Raiders, and I'm going to say this again, yet again, have a bottom five offense, even though they won the game. If you had a good offense, these games aren't even close because of how great the Raiders are playing on defense. And when your running back gets over 124 yards rushing, I mean, come on, guys. Let's be real. Now, if you want nonstop coverage around the silver and black, even if the season's all over, whether it's March, April, May, we got you covered. Hit that big red button. Turn on those notifications. That way you don't miss a thing. So if there's breaking news around a trade, if there's breaking news around a signing in the offseason, I don't want you to miss it. Even now, 8-7, a lot of good stuff. We got 2 weeks left. I promise you, you're going to get videos every single day. Hit that sub button around the number one most watched Raiders channel in the world. Let's go to Alex Thompson. Do believe Carr made Pro Bowl, so I'm going to believe in him. He's not a Pro Bowl quarterback. As long as he wears silver and black, I will believe in him. I will continue to say that I will root for him, but I do not think he's a good quarterback. Can we please stop saying it? Like, he's not a bad quarterback. He's average. And in today's NFL, an average quarterback's 11 to 15. That's where he's at. He's not top 10. Can we please get that out of our head? Let's go to Vonzie Fargus. Defense won us the game. Just won, baby. Thank you, the Lord. I don't want to talk about Derek Carr. I want to talk about the defense. I want to talk about the entire team because that's the other reason why I'm sick of it. I'm so sick and tired of every single postgame show we talk about DC. Let's give credit to the defense. Give credit to Gus Bradley. Give credit to the rest of that Raiders entire team. Their offensive line, Jacobs making second half adjustments. Even Rich Bisaccia making second half adjustments. This game has nothing to do with Derek Carr. Derek, if anything, only hurt the Raiders today. Grade the Raiders defense against the Broncos. A, B, C, D, or F. A plus, A plus, A plus. You gave up only 3 total points, 8 total first downs, 158 total yards, 140 passing yards, 18 rushing yards. They had 10 points off turnovers. The Raiders defense played one of their best games of the season this week. It's an A plus. That's the only grade this Raiders defense gets. Let's go to Venthrak. O-line and defense showed great improvement. Love to see that. I thought Alex Leatherwood had a good game today playing right guard. Sure, Brandon Parker gave up a bad sack, which then led to a Derek Carr fumble. But, I mean, Colt Miller played good. John Simpson, minus his first hold, or I think literally the first offensive play the Raiders had today. I thought he played pretty well. Andre James had himself another great game. Like, this offensive line played good when it mattered the most, and that was in the fourth quarter. Setting up run plays, chewing that clock out. The offensive line deserves a lot of credit. The overall toughness of this team, when it mattered the most, they deserve a lot of credit. Now, I get it, guys. We get a lot of questions that come here during our post-game reaction shows. And if I didn't get to your question, I'm sorry. You can always hit me up on Instagram. I'm at MitchellRents365. So please slide in those DMs. Not afraid to answer your questions. I know I have some questions to get ahead of, but, okay? I am off tomorrow. I will do my best, and I know I was away for the holidays, but I will do my best to answer as many questions as possible. If you want to talk to me about your grades on today, the offense, the defense, anything from top to bottom, please, that's why you follow me on IG, but also to stay up to date on the Raiders news and to stay up on Raiders rumors as well. Let's go to Jesse. How is Carr not top 10 when he's number 2 in passing yards? Because passing yards are, not that they're overrated, but I care about touchdowns. Derek Carr's got 19 touchdowns, 20 touchdowns. He's got 15, 16 turnovers. Passing yards, if anybody says Derek Carr's a top 10 quarterback because he's third in the NFL or second in the NFL because of passing yards, that honestly, Jesse, and I don't mean to be rude here, but that tells me that you don't watch the game and you just look at passing yards. I care about touchdowns. I care about putting points up. Tell me how many good quarterbacks are bottom 5 in the NFL in overall total offense. Please tell me. I'll wait. Let's go to Young. With the weak quarterback draft class and the media supporting Carr for the most part this season, now is the perfect time to trade Carr. You're right. You will not find higher draft value or higher trade value for DC than right now. A lot of good teams out there will trade a first-round pick for Derek Carr, probably more, with him making $19.9 million. Now, sure, if the Raiders end up making the playoffs, but from what I've seen the last 2 weeks, the Raiders did not win because of DC. They won because of the defense. And if I can get a better quarterback, which I really truly believe you can, then you go ahead and you decide to move on. Let's go to Alex Thompson, super chat time. Losing my voice. How many times has DC bailed out the D? He has one wide receiver. Sure, he's bailed out the defense before, but I'm not just talking about before. I'm talking about what I've seen of late. The biggest problem on Carr since basically forever is he plays good in the beginning of the season. He doesn't play well at the end. I get it. You don't have Darren Waller. You don't have Brian Edwards. You have a weak offensive line at times. But today, Derek got bailed out because of a great defensive performance, because of a good running game. And Derek's been bailed out a lot this season because of the Raiders' defense. And I'm sick and tired of us talking about DC. Give credit to the defense, for goodness sakes. So you guys can be the boss. Give me your feedback on the coaching staff today. I want you just your overall thoughts. The first half, I was not all that impressed. But the second half, Bisaccia, Greg Olsen, Gus Bradley, they deserve a lot of credit. The Broncos didn't put up a single point in the second half. They really didn't get anything going. The defense was unbelievable, and I was very, very impressed by the second half adjustments that this Raiders offense, that the Raiders defense, hell, even the special teams, they all made. It was overall a great, great coaching performance today up against the Denver Broncos team. Sure, they didn't have their starting quarterback, but Drew Lock, Teddy Bridgewater, not that Teddy's that much better than Drew Lock. However, I can definitely understand a little bit. So use hashtag Raiders or Super Chat to get your questions or your comments here on the show. If we can't get them anymore, Jack, it's all good. I appreciate everyone who's watching. The Raiders ended up coming away with a win 17-13 over the Denver Broncos in a very close game from top to bottom. If you guys haven't already subscribed to the Raiders Report, please make sure you go ahead and do so. With that Raiders win at 8-7 right now, okay? With everything that's already happened today, the Chiefs, they're about to beat the Pittsburgh Steelers. And because that game is still going on, Pittsburgh 7-6-1. The Raiders right now, here's the current playoff picture. The Raiders have that win, Baltimore, LAC, and the Raiders all sitting there at 8-7. The reason why it's confusing is because Baltimore, if the Ravens win, they go to the, or since the Ravens won, they go to the 7th seed. And then the reason the way that is because they have the tiebreaker over the Chargers. The Chargers have the tiebreaker over the Raiders due to certain conference records as well. That's why that is the way it is. But at the end of the day, the Raiders control their own destiny, which is really all you can care about. If you made it this far in the video, please wish the Raiders some luck going forward. We will be live next week for Raiders against Colts, and I'll be live again on Tuesday, 6 p.m. Eastern Time, 3 p.m. Pacific on the Raiders Report.